Hello students, welcome to my channel. Today's topic is components of food. All living beings such as plants, human beings and animals need certain food components or nutrients for proper growth and to remain healthy. Each of these nutrients is necessary to perform one or the other function in our body. A balanced diet is a diet that contains all the necessary nutrients in the proper amounts. Nutrients present in food: carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals and roughage are the main components of a balanced diet. Carbohydrates give energy, so they are also called energy giving food. For example, rice, chapati, bread, potatoes and bananas contain carbohydrates. The term carbohydrate refers to starch and sugars. Sugars are simple carbohydrates which provide quick energy to the body. For example, sugarcane, grapes, honey and milk. Starch is a complex carbohydrate which releases energy slowly. For example, bread, rice, wheat, potato and corn. Proteins are the building blocks of our body. They repair old, worn out cells and help us to grow. Meat, fish, eggs, milk, pulses and nuts contain proteins. We can get proteins from plant sources and animal sources. Soybean, pulses and nuts are plant source of proteins. Meat, milk, fish, cheese and eggs are animal sources of protein. Fats also give us energy. For example, butter, ghee and oil are rich in fat. Fat can be obtained from both plants and animals. Plant sources: groundnut, coconut oil, sunflower oil, nuts and tilth are some sources of fats obtained from plants. Animal sources: ghee, milk, butter, fish, cream are some of the rich sources of fats obtained from animals. Vitamins are essential for the proper functioning of our body. They help in keeping our eyes, bones, teeth and gums healthy. Our body cannot produce vitamins, so these need to be supplied through the diet. Vitamins are classified into two types: fat soluble and water soluble. Vitamins A, D, E and K are fat soluble, whereas vitamin B complex and vitamin C are water soluble. Minerals Minerals also help in keeping our body healthy. They strengthen the bones and maintain normal heartbeat. They are required in small quantity by the body. Minerals are of two types, macro minerals and trace minerals. Macro minerals are needed in large amount as compared to trace minerals, example calcium, sodium and potassium. We can get these minerals from milk and oranges. Trace minerals are needed in very small amount, for example iron, copper and iodine. We can get these minerals from spinach and salt. Minerals with their sources. First is iron. We can get iron from meat, eggs, green leafy vegetables, apple. It helps in formation of hemoglobin present in red blood cells. Second is calcium. Source is milk, milk products, eggs, broccoli, spinach. It is important for healthy bones and teeth. Third is iodine. Sources are iodized salt and seafood. It promotes physical and mental development in children. Next is phosphorus. Sources are meat, fish, eggs, whole grains. It is important for bones and teeth. Next is sodium and potassium. Sources are common salt, fruits and vegetables. It maintains the balance of water in our body. Next is magnesium. Sources are banana, fish, chicken, green leafy vegetables. It regulates the functioning of nerves and muscles. Next is roughage. Roughage is the part of food derived from plants which does not contain any nutrients but keeps our digestive system healthy. For example, carrots, cucumbers, apples, citrus fruits, kidney beans, whole grains, etc. Water. A human being can survive without food for few weeks, but only for a few days without water. The human body is made up of 70-75% of water. Water performs many functions, such as it absorbs nutrients from the food. It helps our body to get rid of toxic waste through urine and sweat. It helps to maintain constant body temperature. It provides a medium for transportation of substances. Junk food. Junk food is that food which has very little nutrients and fiber but lots of salt, sugar and fat. What happens when a person eats junk food often? All the nutrients are not obtained. The person feels tired. The person often falls sick. The person may become obese. They can get diseases such as diabetes, hypertension, and other heart-related diseases. Now the question is how we can make our diet healthier. We can make our diet healthier by adding curd, salads, fruits and vegetables. We can also include sprouts in our diet. For example, chickpeas, green gram and black gram. Sprouts can be eaten raw or cooked. Other way to make our diet healthy is we can add fermented food. Fermented food are good for digestion because they contain useful bacteria and yeast. For example, idlis, dosa, and dokla. If you want to check your progress, you can do the practice work. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and share.